I heard an incredible thing. Many years ago, at the end of the life of Rabbi Moshe Feinstein, two Bachrim came to speak to Rabbi Moshe Feinstein in Staten Island, when he was in Staten Island, and they came to ask him an end-of-life question about their own mother. They entered into the small room where Rabbi Moshe was. Rabbi Moshe stood up from a table of Svarim, and Rabbi Moshe said, "How can I help you?" And they shared the details with Rabbi Moshe. And Rabbi Moshe gave them a psak halacha. He gave them a verdict in halacha and Jewish law as to what the appropriate path of care was in this end of life. And then Rabbi Moshe asked them a simple question. He said, "I don't mean to meddle, but why are two bachrim, two teenagers, two boys in their early 20s maybe, asking a question about the end of the life of their mother? Where's your father?" The boys sadly shared that their father was nifter. He passed away less than a year ago. They were still in Avelis, in the year of mourning for their father. And now they were coming to inquire about the end of the life of their mother. And Rabbi Moshe began to shake his head. And he said to himself, two boys, he said, "Are you married?" They said, "No, we're Bachrim." And he says, two boys who aren't even married. They don't have a wife to share their agony with. And they have a father that was nifter and a mother that's so sick. And Rabbi Moshe begins to cry bitterly for two boys that he'd never met before, for people that he probably would meet again. But he begins to cry bitter tears. And you could only understand that the two Bachrim, who anyways probably wanted to cry, when one asks such a shayla, how can one not cry? They cry as well. And you have the three of them standing there in the room. Rabbi Moshe the Gadol Hadar, a man in his 90s, standing there and crying, and the two young men crying alongside. And then Rabbi Moshe regains composure. He asks which is the older of the boys. He clasps the boy's hand in his two hands, and he gives them the warmest, most beautiful bracha, that he should find the shidduch, have happiness, and build his own home. And then he does it to the second boy, and he goes back to his gemara. That's a manhig. That's a leader. That's a gadol, someone who could be moved to tears, who could feel the agony and the pain of two people that he never met and probably never will meet. That's a gadol hadar. That's the legacy of Moshe Rabbeinu. It's also the legacy of Rabbi Moshe Feinstein.